I already described how to have S2 cells on your PC. I used an IATC plugin from Nikola Wannabe, which is great for S2 cells in general. Now I found a better solution called Pogo Tools by Alfonso ML, which is dedicated to showing the Pokemon cells, and you can even mark portals as stops or arenas. If you want to know what S2 cells are or how you install IATC on your PC, please watch my last video and use the Pogo Tools plugin URL instead. Today we will install IATC on the phone and use Pogo Tools. Let's get started. By now you should have an Ingress account. This is another game by Niantic, who also released Pokemon Go. You need that Ingress account to access IATC. Since I reckon you already have such an account, let's go to the App Store or Play Store. Folks with an iPhone, install IATC Mobile. All the rest with Samsung or Android devices, install IATC CE. That's the app with the purple icon. Fun fact, on PC you find IATC CE on the new website iatc.app. Once you installed IATC, you need to log in with your Ingress account. On iPhone, your map is most likely black now since the base map cannot be loaded. Go to Menu, to Base Layer and switch to Google Roads. We will find something prettier later. Now we need to install the plugin. Search for GitLab Pogo S2 on the internet or take the link in the description to go to Alfonso's GitLab page. Alfonso has a very good description. I show the installation on iPhone first because it's easier, and after that for other smartphones. For iPhone, push and hold the link until you see the menu with which you can copy the URL. With the URL copied, go back to IATC, click the gear on the upper right corner for settings. Click on User Scripts and add another user script by pressing the plus sign in the upper right corner. Here you paste the copied URL and you're done. Go back to Plugins and scroll down to the headline layer. There you find the user script Pogo Tools. Click it and the blue checkmark shows that the plugin is activated now. Go back and back, and now you have Pogo Tools with S2 cells. Now for all the rest. You are on Alfonso's GitLab page and click on the link for Android. Either IATC will open up and wants to install the plugin right away, then you are fine. Or you need to download the plugin first. The file with the extension .js or .txt is now probably in your download folder. If the plugin is not automatically installed, go back to IATC, go to Settings in the upper right corner, then to Plugins, then to Add External Plugin in the upper right. Acknowledge the warning and click Add External Plugin again. Navigate to the folder on your file system where s2check.user.js is located and choose this file. The app asks you if you want to install it and you choose yes. You now need to activate the plugin. Go back and you see a user plugin with layer. Click on it and you find Pogo Tools. Click it and the checkmark will show that it's activated. Done. To make the map as beautiful as possible now, go to Menu, Overlay Layers and deactivate Fields and Links, since you don't need those unless you want to play Ingress. Do you want to have a nicer base map? Go to Settings, IATC Plugins, scroll down to Map Tiles. OpenStreetMap shows a nice map and you should try it out. To activate the map, go to Menu, Base Layers. We've already been here in the beginning. Besides Google Roads, you can try CartoDB or OpenStreetMap, which shows many additional information. At the bottom, there is a text, tap here for Info Screen. There you will find the Pogo settings. Choose This is Pogo. to hide unneeded information. Now you can create your own Pogo map. Click on portals and choose whether these are stops, arenas or NA for a portal which is not available in Pokemon Go. Not all ingress portals are available in Pokemon Go since they need to have a minimum distance. With Pogo Action, the button besides Pogo settings, you can export or import your list of stops and arenas. But this would be too much for this video to explain, and I leave it as a homework for you to figure out. Now you have the nice Pokemon Go S2 cells and you can create your Pogo map and even share it with your friends and your community. One last thing, if you use IETC Mobile on iPhone, go to Settings and change the IETC version under MISC to IETC CE Release Build. IETC.me is currently no longer in development and IETC CE will receive future updates. That wasn't too complicated, was it? If you got stuck somewhere, rewind this video and watch it again or post a comment below. I try to help as good as I can. Thanks for watching. I wish you a wonderful day. I am Florian and you are awesome.